okay.
I can hear myself.
Hold up. I'm gonna check these levels.
Damn.
Thank you. origin of the phoenix. All ends with beginnings. What keeps the planet spinning? The force from the beginning.
Yeah.
Your love is perfection. Please point me in the right direction. I'ma give you all my affection. Every touch becomes infectious. Let's make out in this Lexus. There's no other love just like this. I like what you, I wonder, can we become love's persona? You'll always be the one that I wanna come up to, girl. Let me love you, show you how special you are. I wanna be your baby. You'll always be my baby. Tell me what you want. Sing it to the world. Baby, give me some. Give me some. You gon' be my girl. I wanna make it mine. And it ain't nobody's business. It ain't nobody's business. It ain't nobody's business. It ain't nobody's business. Just mine and my baby. It ain't no, it ain't no, it ain't no, it ain't no, it ain't no. Ain't nobody's business. That it ain't nobody's business. It ain't nobody's business. That ain't nobody's business.
Everybody get up.
We're here, GIDradio.com, digital empire in the building.
Hey, hey. Hey, hey.
We have our special guest, DJ Naturally, on the ones and twos.
Yeah, getting used to the equipment.
Yes.
It's all good, it's all good. So what was the playlist you started with?
I'm sorry?
What was the playlist you started with? What song?
Of course, Chris Brown, Fine China, you know that.
Uh-huh.
And then that's a new song by Pharrell. Actually, it's Daft Punk featuring Pharrell.
Right.
It's called Get Lucky.
Okay.
And then that last song was Robin Thicke's new song with T.I. and Pharrell. It's called Blurred Lines.
Yes. Sounds good. Once again, I'm Little Nat.
And I'm Big Kitch.
Big Kitch in the building.
Yeah, yes.
We got super producer Knowledge, who's silent all the time.
Yeah, he don't like to talk.
And this is Digital Empire Nation Radio Show on GIDradio.com.
Yeah.
And if you want to holler at us, what's the number, Kitch? 212? He just told us.
Yeah, he did. And I've been sipping on his Henny, please.
Let me
964.
964-1307.
All right, listen, we got to have a Henny break. Like, just let me know, because I'm sipping on Henny right now.
That's right. So the number is 212-967-1307. 1-3-0-4-0-7-0-7-1-3-0-7.
Was you sipping something too?
I just did.
Oh, okay.
212-967-1307. So again, let me just introduce you guys to the show just in case, because it's the second show. Digital Empire Nation is a radio show to introduce DJs, up and coming, big names, all of that. We all about the DJ. We all about the music. We also want to introduce up and coming artists, big name artists, fashion designers, filmmakers, actors, models. This is a platform for any and anybody to be here. Anybody that owns a business, if you a lawyer, entertainment lawyer, or you sell real estate, whatever it is, we are here to interview you and give you a platform. We got a lot of platforms too.
Oh, yes.
We got littlenat.com.
Yeah, we got focusmag.com.
And Knowledge got a whole bunch of stuff.
Yeah,
himself.
Knowledge is on some other. He on some underground stuff. He don't want to be seen. You know.
Plus, we got my cooking show on the back burner where celebrities cook their favorite meals too. So we got a lot of platforms for you guys to do your thing. So it's all about DJ Naturally in the building. Who I've known this young lady
a long time.
She was my supervisor at Kiss FM.
Get out.
And her last name is Bowen. Mine is Barrington. So they couldn't call us MB because we both Natalie.
Yeah.
So Flex gave us the name, and she hated it.
Come on.
Flex, this is how Little Nat got started. We did production at Kiss. She was my supervisor. I was her assistant.
All right.
So we both ran the boards for Flex on the weekend. She did Friday night. I did Saturday night.
All right.
So he didn't know what to call us because both our last names begin with B, so he couldn't say MB or whatever.
Yeah.
So he was like, okay, since she's taller than me, he's going to call her Big Nat and call me Little Nat.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. She hated that.
Everybody thought I was fat.
Okay. She hated that.
If you just listening and you ain't looking, she's far from fat. I'm just saying.
Very much so. Beautiful young lady over there.
Yes, she's far
from
fat.
So she taught me everything I knew about commercial radio and production.
She knew a lot already, though. Jay Dixon.
Well, actually, Jay and Chris Mercado helped us a lot. So,
yeah. Chris Mercado.
And so what you doing now, Nat?
Just
besides
DJing.
DJing, you do a lot of parties and stuff, right?
Yeah, I do a lot of parties, a lot of special events. I got a party coming up this Sunday, the Locks.
Okay.
That's what's up.
Make sure you come through. It's in Brooklyn, y'all that are familiar.
Come on,
BK!
Locks is on Putnam.
Okay, good. Get a whole address.
The hood.
Yeah, give the whole address. Give the whole address because
it's 15 Putnam Avenue between, I believe it's Downing and Cambridge.
All right, because we got a lot of transplants that ain't from Brooklyn.
Oh, okay.
You know, they got a lot of transplants. Like, you know, let's just keep it honest.
Used to be a little dicey neighborhood, but now.
It ain't that dicey because.
Now it's not dicey anymore.
You got the Caucasoids up there. I'm sorry.
whatsoever do you mean?
I love my Caucasoid friends.
It's real safe now, and it's got a backyard, so it's cute.
Mm.
So come check it out. It starts at 5.
Are you still doing production? I remember the last time when I saw you saying you was producing music.
No, I do production for my own.
Okay.
That's what's
up. I have an internet radio station coming out, but.
All right.
But yeah.
Oh, nice. Good for you.
I mean, I'll have you as a guest, of course.
Of course. I would love to come.
Could I guest too? I don't do nothing but just talk shit.
Okay. Well, we always need that.
All right. Good.
You got a good radio voice, though.
Don't tell him that.
You could probably do some drops or a sound station or something.
We're sponsored by Hennessy and Drunkness.
Speaking of great voice,
Oh, geez.
Somebody went on vacation for 2 days. I know somebody else heard that nice great voice. Boom, bang. Yeah, baby.
Can you
tell he's relaxed, people?
I am very relaxed. And a crazy shout out to my friend, Stephanie Michelle. She is awesome. She's the bomb. I had a really good time.
Wow.
Yes.
I know you did. Posting up the pool and how you got your little spa going on.
No. Hold on. Let me just say something. She lied to me. She tricked me.
How she tricked you?
Because I'm thinking I'm going to relax. She made me work out. I'm in the gym.
Oh, that's good.
I'm in the gym. My whole body's sore, man.
You need to work out. So when she gets you in the bedroom, your stamina's
Who said
up
we
there.
Going to the bedroom? That's just a friend. Like, how does that? Like, that. That's
you know how friends turn into making love. It does eventually.
I do love her though.
Don't front like you didn't want to poke it. You poked it?
No.
You didn't hit it?
No. We don't do that. No. And even if I did, I wouldn't kiss and tell. I wouldn't tell you. At least not.
Not on the radio?
Not on the radio. But no, we good people. But she did lie to me, and I had to work out.
No, you know what? Shout out to her, because you needed to. We were supposed to go to the gym.
Yeah, we was.
So now that she got you started, boom, bang, you back home now?
Damn, that means I'm in the gym every night, because I got to continue what I started with her.
Exactly.
Jesus, Nelly.
Exactly.
All right, listen, I'm going to just say this right now for everybody listening. If I do this, and I start looking like 50 with the six-pack, Don't yell at me when I'm walking around the street and I'm coming to job interviews with no shirt and just a tie. Don't get mad.
They're not going to call you big sexy for nothing, this the right?
This is the monster that y'all created.
Yeah, they're not going to call you big sexy for nothing, though.
They still don't call me big sexy for nothing.
We call you big sexy.
I'm big sexy.
Yeah, on GIDRadio.com.
At least in my mind, I'm big sexy.
Digital Empire Nation. Yes. So, Nat.
Yes. Yes, Nat.
It's been a bit.
We used to do that at work.
Yeah, all the time. All the time.
Hey, Nat. It's Nat.
It's
hey,
Nat. It's Nat. So our friend, Mr. C, got caught again.
Girl.
Yo, my phone couldn't stop blowing up that whole weekend. And it's like, okay, I haven't been at the station for like a year now.
Yeah.
So why is everybody calling me? I know your phone rang. Did your phone ring? No?
No, it's been a long time since.
Oh, okay.
Me and Mr. C, yeah. Each other.
Yeah.
But I was surprised because, I didn't know we hung out a little bit.
I lied. All of us did. He never, but I was talking on my other radio show yesterday about it. It was kind of uncomfortable because that's my boy. That's family. You know, I know Mr. C for years.
Yeah.
And he's always supported me. So they were asking me questions like, have you ever seen him do stuff? Did he ever even give you a hint of anything? And he's not like that.
No.
He's very private. You agree, right?
Yeah, he's very private.
You don't never see, like, I must have seen C with, like, maybe three girlfriends or so. And I was surprised to even see him because he keeps his personal life
very personal.
Very personal.
For a reason. I'm just saying.
So to hear that he got caught a third time, my problem is not who he sleep with. I don't care who he sleep with. Mm-hmm. You know, if you get straight,
that's your
whatever.
Business.
But it's the prostitution thing I got a problem with.
You know what it is for me? It's the same thing, but you got to understand that he has a brand to protect. Mm-hmm. And he's not protecting that brand. And it's not even the Hot 97 brand. It's his brand.
Yeah.
And the thing that I found really funny is that Ebro brought him on a station that Monday to clear it.
Right. What do you think about the interview? What did you think about the interview?
I thought it did more harm than good.
Yes.
Sure enough.
And it was more on his part.
Yeah.
Because let's be honest here. Hot 97 or corporate entity, we're not even going to say Hot 97, a corporate entity is looking to protect certain things, right? All he had to do was say, this is what I am. Mm-hmm. And they will keep him on the air. But if he continue to go out and get prostitutes, like Ebro said, you're doing criminal acts now. We have a reason to fire you. And he thinking like, oh, I'm Mr. C.
Three times, yeah.
Yes. He thinking, I'm Mr. C. No, but you are Mr. C. But then we got Chuck that was up here last week. We got Scratch that could fill that position. We got a whole bunch of...
And there's a lot of young DJs ready for that slot. They're just waiting.
Yeah. Yep. So they gave him an opportunity to protect himself, and he didn't take that.
I remember before Mr. C had that spot. I don't know if you were at the station yet. It was Red Alert.
Yeah, I was there.
And exactly.
We kind of knew. We were like, well,
Red Alert had the, it was the old school at noon.
Yep.
And then Mr. C got that
and
spot.
Red Alert did
you know they're not doing a throwback anymore.
Yeah, I just found out tonight.
Yes, Mr. CNU, no more throwbacks. So he's got to be really careful because they making changes. And you know when they make changes, sometimes change is not good all the time.
Yeah.
It's very scary. So my thing is, I just want him to be careful. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, protect
he
himself.
He has the right to keep his private life to himself.
Yes, exactly.
You know, if he don't want to say anything about it, that's cool.
Yeah.
But just be careful. You know, there's hotels, dog, like... Do your business in a hotel.
Listen, there's a lot of gay dudes in the game. We know this.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You can find you a boyfriend and keep it on the low.
Yeah.
And just do what you do.
Yeah.
That's all it is.
Like Lauryn Hill, she keeps her stuff on the low except for paying her taxes.
Paying her taxes. Yeah, forget about that.
You know, oh, hey. We didn't hear about that whole life or Wyclef thing until years later when she married one of the Bob Marley's kids. Yeah. I think Wyclef and his wife put some voodoo stuff on her because she has never been the same.
That's so wrong.
For real, like she's been a mess, right? Like how she performing, she coming 3 hours late, then she's singing garbage.
All right, listen.
I saw her at Rock the Bell. She was pretty good.
Okay.
A couple years ago, or last summer or two.
I'm gonna make a confession.
What's that?
I wanted to be Lauren's personal stalker so I could save her from the madness.
He's like the fourth or fifth guy that I know that said that.
Hey.
So many guys I know have been like, oh, I'm in love with her. I would have married her. I used to stare at her in the studio when I was in the studio.
Hey.
She's a beautiful woman, and I don't know what happened to her. Talented. She just lost it.
You know what happened to her? We could say this because we on radio. Good dick. Good dick happened to her.
Yeah, you know what? That is so true.
Good
we
dick.
Women get confused with love and good dick.
I mean,
we get good dick and we think we in love.
Yes.
It's a big difference. Because once shit is over, then what?
I've given out good dick once or twice.
I said once or twice?
Once or twice.
At least you're honest.
I received some good dick every once in a while.
I was going to say, I've gotten it about once or twice.
Yeah, not from everybody. There's a few that was like, woo.
Make you start saying, make you start doing shit. And now I've had some good pussy every once in a while.
Once or twice.
Make you do things.
Yes, yeah, making her not pay her goddamn taxes.
Now, it won't make me do that.
Yeah, no, like, what is up with celebrities not paying their taxes?
You know what it is? Is I think they got a lot of people in their ear. And because they got all these people in their ear, you got one person that's like, yeah, I'm going to take care of you. Oprah said something that was really important. Sign your own fucking checks. They got people
signing
checks.
Did she tell that to Toni Braxton?
Yes. And then Toni Braxton, look at Toni Braxton's ass. She didn't sign her own check.
Yeah, you got to take care of your business, first and foremost. You got to make sure Uncle Sam get paid, because he's going to get paid regardless you pay him or not. He's going to take the money. Not only did she's Lauryn Hill's got getting locked up, right, for 3 months or something like
three
that.
Months, yeah.
She still got to pay that money.
Yes.
Yep.
Exactly.
Ja Rule just got out. Wait, he got out for his crime and then now got locked up. Yep. As soon as he walked out, got locked up for tax.
Exactly.
Like, they not playing. They don't care.
Hey. Listen.
But I knew that.
Sign your own checks. Do your bills like you was doing them when you was broke.
Mm-hmm.
That's all you really have to do. Continue to do your bills the way you was doing it when you was broke.
Exactly.
That's all it is.
Lauryn Hill did a she has a new record out. Did you find it?
Yeah, I have it.
You want to get into that?
I didn't hear it yet. This is my first time.
Yo, you gotta hear this.
Oh, you'll love it.
Okay.
You gotta hear this.
I might have to get up and dance.
And then after you play that, you could go into your set, and then we'll talk about it when you finish your set. It's GIDRadio.com, Digital Empire Nation, baby.
All right.
In a joke town, metaphor for coke town, commerce and grooming, run the whole world, man. Bone drunk and debauchery, old world brutality, whole world kill softly, whole world run savage.
We
play the pride fiends, program TV screens, quick scam and drag queens, real life the blast fiends, think twice, past dream, crime if you ask clean, quick, fast, the poison has entered the bloodstream, psychological master, consequence of tragedy, mythological characters, men and women is parody, superficial abandoned, borderline insanity, out of order, humanity, crime committed so passively, just arrives in casualties, corporations for batteries, explanations and strategies.
See, they dead, they on the set.
Own Jones and bankrupt, grown people so corrupt. Vice lords and yellow men, junkies and popularity. Culture so independent, culture scavenge reality. Past feeling depravity, decaying social cavity. Preying on human ignorance, popular immorality. Symptoms of disease, hemp, population misled. Self-indulgent past that, absence to the godhead. Hemp, social symbology, nepotism, no artistry. Despotism and piracy, desperation, dishonesty. Business decision, policy, more money, less equality. Inflating global ego, imitating reality. Pseudo-psycho, new family, poisonous, bulls and arrows. Hypocritics on salary, idle hands, devil's agency. Predisposed to complacency, jealousy and audacity. Contagious social gluttony, stages of mass malignancy. Epidemic deception, generation and atrophy. Glam life and debt, scam life and editors. By privacy and neglect, children hiding from creditors. Absence of self-respect, falling scared of competitors. Lost out of luxury at someone's expense. Sensitive children, used up in sacrifice. Blind to consequence, smoked up in dope pipes. Ecstasy, fast life, recklessly past life. Narcotics and cash fights, derived society. Benefactors turned actors, addictions, triple captives. Experience manufacturing, it's neurotic, toxic society.
I'm
comments of who the Marxist is. 10,000 pictures on Facebook, it's like the pot calling the kettle narcissist. Come on, really, saying the devil, but you're the chief arsonist. Hypocrites can't even see their own part in this. No reflection, vampire paradigm, no introspection. Star that, star rants as a breakdown. 3 months before, pure obsession, picture can't take down. Children, it's a shakedown, they just looking for a sacrifice. They've been doing this since before Bobby Darren sang Mac the Knife. Before James Dean's car into the jackknife. Perhaps it's because they lack life or lack guts. Never confuse the head with the butt. Opinions are like assholes and most of them stink. I was told by a woman, so rethink. Don't ever let them lead you to drink. Doubt, need you to fall, get up, stand up, cast Lucifer out, shake it up, baby, watch them twist and then shout, insecure assholes looking for a ticket to ride on somebody like the picket, it's fucking wicked, shame on them, this erotic toxic society.
Still got a flow though, still rhyme, and she could give Nicki Minaj a run, nobody else.
Psychopsychology and desperate need of psychiatry, exorcism, sobriety, forcing social lobotomies, people stuck in dichotomies, pseudo-sicko anxieties, serial criminals dressed in variety, social transvestism, subliminal dressed up as piety, transference projections like Cartesian images, robbing innocence, stealing inheritance, quiet victims with no defense, betrayed over dollars and cents, maladjusted and ignorant, malediction and dissonance. Too much addiction, no consciousness. Don't trust it. This cosmology's busted. Broken and returns to the dust. This thinks of corruption, oppression, deceit, abuse, and repeat. They don't feel complete unless they rob with the sheep. Man is not a product if you call him that to stop this. And it's neurotic, godless society.
Yes. Her pistol dog. Her pistol dog. I said her pistol dog. Cause she a fashion killer and I'm a trendy figure. I said her pistol dog. Her pistol dog. I said her pistol dog. Cause she a fashion killer and I'm a jiggy figure. Rockin', rollin', swaggin' to the max, fashion killer, she be busy poppin' tags. She got a lot of Prada, that Dolce & Gabbana, I can't forget Escada, and that Balenciaga. I'm sippin' purple, see my aunt your mama, and if you is a rider, we go shopping like Manana. Her attitude Rihanna, she get it from her mama, she jiggy like Madonna, but she trippy like Nirvana, cause everything designer, her jeans helmet lane, shoes is Alexander Wang, and her shirt the newest Donna Karen, wearing all the Cartier frames, Jean Paul Gaultier's, cause it match with her persona. Her pistol go. Her pistol go. I said her pistol go. Cause she a fashion killer, and I'm a trendy figure. I said her pistol go. Her pistol go. Her pistol go. Cause she a fashion killer and I'm a jiggy figure. I said I see a Jill Sanders, Oliver Peoples, Costume National, yeah, and a Mueller Meester. See this them be the sneaker, Mon Bon Balmain, Goya by the trunk, Isabel Moron. I love your Linda Farrow, I adore your Dior, your Damien Doma, be the carrot from the store. I'm crashed down with that top down. How I ride round, mommy in that Tom Ford, poppy in that Tom Brown, Rick Owens, Rav Simmons, boy she got it by the stop. She ballin' till she fall, that means she shopping till she drop. And Versace got a lot, but she may never wear it, but she saved it so her babies will be flyer than their parents. And her pistol go, her pistol go. I said her pistol go. Cause she a fashion killer, and I'm a trendy figure. I said her pistol go. Her pistol go. I said her pistol go. Cause she a fashion killer, and I'm a jiggy figure. I said her pistol go.
Black tees, breeze in the wind. Smiling as your treasure, you're so well put together. Us bags and rings, jeans and shoes. Spikes and patent knives, different fabrics, what's it got to have? You and me and you. Go away together, we could get away forever.
All emotions clash and thrash, and someone turned the light out. I met my baby, such my passion on my fashion night out.
Her pistol go. Her pistol go. Her pistol go. I said her pistol go. Cause she a fashion killer, and I'm a trendy figure. I said her pistol go. Her pistol go.
Got me up all night. All I'm singing is love songs. She got me up all night. Constant drinking and love songs. She got me up all night. Down and out with these love songs. She got me up all night. Drowning out with these love songs. She got me up all night. Yeah, all I'm singing is love songs. She got me up all night. Yeah, constant drinking in love songs. She got me up all night. Yeah, drowning out with these love songs. She got me open all night. Got me open all night.
Okay, back when I was sleeping in my mama crib, even back when I was up there in Muhammad crib, paying $1,700 for the rent, money well spent, no heater but a nigga may eat, may I vent, had a thing for you, even wrote the song Dreams for you, cause I had dreams for your thoughts of a ring, for your childish shit, you know childish shit, anonymous flower scent, you know coward shit, now a nigga signed a hoe, took a power trip, back home, I'm grown now, and the city's my throne now, huh? The same clubs that I used to get tossed out, like got crisscrossed, totally crossed out, cause now I'm in this bitch. And I'm totally bossed out. Old six crying cause they know that they lost out. But I'm still on you, I'm still on you. My drinks spill on me while I fell on you. I'm saying,
would you believe me if I said I'm in love? Baby, one
Yeah, this has gotta be the longest crush ever. If I ever get the fuck, it'd be the longest bus ever. Love is a drug like the strongest stuff ever. And fuck it, I'm on one. You feel me? She on a power trip, she got me where she want a nigga. Wifing in the club, man, my homies gon' disown a nigga. Like, give me $20. Ask stupid how you get to college. I'm in your city and I'm wondering if you're home now. Went and found a man, but I'm hoping you alone now. Can't help but feeling like I dropped the ball, cliche. I used to pop up on you at the mall each day. Now typically I kick game like East Bay, but you got a nigga freeze frame yelling please play. For Pete's sake, homie, pull it together. Just fuck up one time and be through it forever. But
would you believe me if I said I'm in love? Baby, what you want? She got me up all night, constant drinking and love songs. She got me up all night, down and out with these love songs. She got me up all night, down and out with these love songs. She got me up all night, yeah. All I'm singing is love songs. She got me up all night, yeah. Constant drinking and love songs. She got me up all night, yeah. Down and out with these love songs. She got me open all night, got me open all night, hey.
GIDRadio.com,
yes.
Digital Empire Nation Radio Show. I'm Little Nats.
I'm Big Kitch. I'm Big
Super
Kitch.
Producer Knowledge Bone. DJ Naturally on the sets.
Yep, yep.
And we played that new Lauryn Hill.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I told you.
Okay.
I told you. She had to rush to make that before she got locked up. She could have saved that one.
She couldn't even. Don't save it. Destroy it. I'm sorry.
It was terrible.
Delete it. And I love me some Lauryn. You know the things I do to Lauryn? Oh, my God. I'm just saying, but that, no. Anyway, but not that song, no.
No, she could have saved that. So, you have a shout-out for
Yes, I got a shout-out to my boy, Karell Velez, man. He actually was going to call in and start some trouble, but he couldn't because he just had his baby.
Oh, congratulations.
Yes.
Welcome to the world.
Yes, Jace Christopher Velez. This is his third boy.
Nice.
Third boy.
We can't get girls now? He's not popping no girls, huh?
Nah. We trying to build a basketball team.
He didn't move the penis to the right. He just kept it left.
Hey. 801. And he was going to be on the air right now. But that's my dude, man. Karell Velez. Shout out to you.
Congratulations,
bro.
So we have a special guest for Mother's Day. And not just for Mother's Day. This special person has a beautiful, fabulous fashion line, accessory line. I had the pleasure of meeting her and hosting her fashion show for Fashion Week in February. And when I met this young lady, I just loved her right away. She has such a beautiful personality and she has so much more going for her. She's not just a fashion stylist, but she has a lot of stuff going on, but we'll talk to her about it. Please show some love to the beautiful Miss Royale in the building.
Yes, yes.
Thank you. Oh my God, this is special.
How you doing?
I'm doing great now that I'm here with you guys.
Thank you. You look beautiful, by the way.
Thank you.
Yes, she does.
She's like, are we going to be on screen anything? Because I have to get it together. I was like, yeah, we're going to be on TV.
I'm going to say all my fellas, all my dudes, y'all need to go online right now and look. And it's two of them. It's two of them.
Yes, her co-host. What's your name?
Jazzy.
Hi, Jazzy. That's what we call my gossips. Is your name Jasmine or just Jasmine?
Jasmine.
Yeah, my gossip's name is Jasmine. I got two gossips named Jasmine, by the way. So it's nice meeting you.
You too.
So tell us about yourself.
Okay.
Tell us the history behind your fashion line and how you got started and everything.
Wow. The history is a lot of trials and tribulations,
And I think for the most part, the adversity is what makes us stronger. Prior to starting The Line, I used to style for MTV. I did the whole Nick at Night when they brought back the old shows.
Wow.
So I was just like hustling, getting the wardrobe. And in between that, going back to school for my MBA, I had a short fall. Kind of broke a bunch of bones, like about 10 bones.
Oh, wow.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So I was like on crutches for 6 months, on a wheelchair for 6 months. And during that time, I said, you know what? I had an epiphany. And the epiphany was to create, to stop, you know, playing around and create my own line. So while I'm sitting on the wheelchair and learning to walk again, I decided to just go in.
Oh.
And I developed my first collection while being in that state.
Wow.
So that's how you came up with the name of your fashion
line.
Yes,
Epiphany or More. The Epiphany and the More of the line.
Nice. That is an interesting story.
Yes.
Thank you.
And if you need the broken bones massaged, you let me know.
I'm just saying. After dark.
Wow. Big Sexy, you ready for that?
I got my after dark voice on. Yes.
All right.
So you have a summer spring fashion line coming up, right?
Yes. Next week, Saturday, we will be at Pulse 48. It's a club in Brooklyn, formerly known as CPAC.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And we're going to do it big there. We're going to have a bunch of other designers, also new designers who are coming up, because I really want to create that platform for those designers and those artists to come out and show their stuff, because they don't really have that opportunity, like what you guys are providing here.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
So besides the beautiful things that you designed, can you guys see her accessories? She created this.
Nice.
Her ring, everything. She's just so gorgeous. I love the uniqueness of your line.
Thank
you. There's no one out there that has anything like you.
I appreciate that. Thank
you. I like different stuff, because when stuff is different than that, it's not dated. You know, you can wear it all the time.
Absolutely.
And that's what I like about your line. So besides like the accessory stuff, what else do you design? You design women's clothes, men's clothes?
I'm trying to get rid of this cold that's following me everywhere I go. But I designed for different individuals, celebrities. One of my biggest clients is Olivia. Olivia may ask for a special piece, and I'll give it to her. Akon's artist, very humble young woman named Lauren Amber.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So if someone calls me up and say, you know what, Royu, I want a specific piece and I want it to look like this, then I'll do it for them. They just have to hit me up.
Okay, that is great. So what else do you do besides fashion? I know you do a lot of other things.
Yes, I started a committee known as the Power of the Stilettos, and Jasmine is the vice president of the committee.
Okay. Right. Jasmine, you want to tell us about that?
Yeah.
Okay.
She said okay.
The Power of Stilettos is basically we're building a platform for young women.
Okay.
Young women and women out there trying to make it out there and want to be something and talk about things. Not only for
music
women and men too.
No, we decided that we was going to just keep it for women, powder stilettos, and we're going to focus on women in the music, fashion, film, production field.
Okay.
So we come together and we exchange networks and we coexist together and co-brand together.
Cool.
And not only do we network with each other, we also provide the opportunity for the young women who want to learn about the business to join in, even if they don't have one. And we also do a lot of charity work. So that's like one of my biggest things is giving back to the community, especially Brooklyn. All day.
Brooklyn.
East New York.
All day.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Knowledge looked at me like, oh, okay. New York in the building.
What made you want to do that? Because, I mean, you're starting out and you know, when you're starting, you know, you're doing the fashion thing, but what made you want to, you know, do the community thing?
Well, my background is psychology. I used to be a psychotherapist, and I dealt with a lot of teen moms.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
all right.
So I see, like, the potential that a lot of these young women have, but they just don't have that individual in, or team of people that say you can do it regardless of whatever you went through.
Oh, okay.
So that was always one of my biggest things, was no matter what I'm doing in life, to make sure that I give back something. Even if I'm making nothing and I'm not successful in anything else, at least I know I did that.
That's what's up. That's what's up.
I love anybody that does anything for the community. I'm big on that, like, because it's so many talented people out there and they don't know how to get started in whatever business they want to be in. So especially our young teens, they're so lost.
Absolutely.
And the school system is so messed up. It's so bad. And it's like, when we can come and give back, that is such a great thing to do. So what you're doing, especially for women, is awesome. I applaud you for that.
Thank you so much.
Definitely,
very much so.
Definitely.
So now Nicki Minaj was invited to the Met, and everybody was like getting in her case, you know, they were like, why she invited? Blah, blah, blah. You know, everybody got their love-hate situation with Nicki Minaj. And Beyonce wore this fabulous dress, but they made fun of Kim Kardashian's dress.
God.
They made it like a couch. Did you see it on Instagram?
I saw that. I saw that.
Did you see
floral,
that? They had her hugging Kanye. He was sitting on her.
She needs to stop letting Ye design dresses. You're like styling him.
They
like,
need to get you.
Hello.
Yes.
Let's work on that.
She's forgetting her sexy. Messing around with that dude.
Yeah, she really is.
All right?
Because he thinks he knows everything
about
women's fashion.
And he thinks that he's prettier than everybody else.
Oh, God. He got an issue. All right. I love Kanye's music, but sometimes he gets a little bit too spoiled and too, like, act like a girl sometimes. Like, relax.
I can't deal with those guys. I like a manly man.
Me too.
Hey,
me too. A nice and rugged, nice and rugged manly man, right?
Yeah. Like, you don't worry about shaving every day. It's okay. Put on the same jeans. It's all right.
That's what men are supposed to do.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
So the reason why I brought that up is because I don't know if you saw any pictures or anything, but did you, you know, is there anything you would have, like, styled differently for Nicki? Her dress was okay, but I think she could have brought something different to the table.
Well,
she had on this black dress. It was, like, cut out to
and
the
her
side.
Hair was, like, really wild.
I like the hair. The hair was nice.
I love the hair. I definitely am with you on that one. She could have done something
better. The dress.
I love her. I love her stylist because they do.
They do style her very well, and she's always different, especially for her her magazine photos and stuff like that.
Yeah. I have to, like, really respect the hairstylist because they take a lot of my pieces, so yay. But as far as the dress, you know, I think the whole American Idol thing has transitioned her to a different phase. And she may be kind of losing really what she wants to do just because she has to maintain now
that pop stardom.
Pop stardom, Nicki, that's on American Idol. So I think that probably has something to do with it, not so much that she wanted that dress.
Yeah, probably she has to tone it down a little, maybe.
Definitely.
So is there any celebrity out there did you would like to style for?
I would love to style, let's see, Adele. Mm. I think that something totally different from what I'm used to.
Mm-hmm.
I love her music, and I think she, you know, for a white girl, she has a lot of style.
Mm-hmm.
I like her.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I want to style more DJs, so...
Naturally,
need
you hear that?
Yes.
And we always doing events.
Rebranding.
Since I'm up here with ladies, I'm just going to interrupt y'all for a second. My fellas is like, tell her to turn to the camera.
I know. She's a little shy.
Turn to the camera, Jasmine.
That's Jazzy right there, guys.
Jasmine, I met Jasmine a few years ago, and I started off as her mentor. All
right. Okay.
And I'm still mentoring her. And I must say, here on the radio, in front of everyone in the room, the listeners, the people watching, you have grown and evolved to a beautiful young lady, very business-minded, and she works hard.
That's good.
That's great.
She's my right-hand girl.
That's excellent.
That's what's up.
I just came
that's
from
cool.
school right now.
Oh, yeah? What school you go to?
York College in Queens.
Nice. York College. Oh, you all the way by my place where I live. York College is by us.
I have no idea.
The E-Train, Parsons and Archer. What you majoring?
Business.
Very good major. Stick to that. I chose radio, television, and film. Great major. Hard to get into. Hard to stay into that field. So you taking business was a smart thing to do. Because you never can not have that.
So
you always need that.
So when I get, like, rich, I'm gonna have to like hire a bunch of women around me. I mean, I love y'all. I really do.
This guy. That's why we call him the Big Sexy. He loves women.
I love all of them.
I like that name.
And speaking of Big Sexy, Big Sexy Kid.
Look, when you start making big boy clothes,
I got you. Remember, I said custom too. So I got you.
Oh damn, I haven't got my.
I am gonna go into that. I am gonna go this fall. Mm-hmm. I'm looking into doing more men accessories and clothing.
You do shoes too, don't you?
The shoes will be launched in July.
Nice. Yeah. I love shoes.
Yeah, I know. I'm gonna hook you up. I got you.
So speaking of hooking up, we have a Mother's Day gift courtesy of Epiphany from Miss Royale, and she wants to give it away to all you great mothers out there, especially single moms. And you know what? I'm going to shout out single dads because they get mad when we get shouted out for Father's Day.
Thank you.
They hate that. I'm going to shout out all the single fathers. There's a lot of single fathers out
very
there.
Very good.
Thank you very much.
So happy Mother's Day to you too.
Absolutely.
So since it's Mother's Day, you can call up now. What number should we say? Call a number what?
212-967.
I said what? Not the call. That what number? Like from 1 to 10? Call a what?
Jesus,
call a
7.
Call a
7. Lucky 7.
Favorite number. There you go.
Call a number 7 right now. And now give us the number,
baby. 212-967-1307.
212-967-1307. We have a Mother's Day gift to you guys, courtesy of our beautiful friend here, Miss Royale.
Yes.
All right. And we're going to get back to the music. And then we come back, we get a winner. And congratulate you guys.
And maybe even a lap dance from Knowledge.
That's after dark.
Hi, Mommy. You did well. We got to get some pictures. All right.
Don't cry.
I'm almost certain. As a matter of fact, let me look at the. It's coming back on.
Yeah.
All right. She has one more thing she wanna mention.
For me, it might not be for you. Did you post it?
No, it might be. Yeah.
I have Sprint, and Sprint sucks. Yeah, she asked me if I post a picture. Hello, hello, hello.
No, I was seeing if she had posted a picture, I was going to repost it.
No, I saw it.
Really?
I think so. I said she was calling one.
Oh, okay. I got it.
That's Lisa. Lisa
looks
like an idiot. I love her though. Sorry, we can still hear us on the mic.
Straight minutes. No new friends. Still here with my day one, so you hear me say, No new friends. Still ride with my day one, don't really need no new friends. I stay down from day one, so I said, No new friends. Stay down from day one, so I say, no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no, 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 yeah.
dig me, and I'm tired of all this hating. I thank God for my patience. I thank God for my homies. I wish we could trade places. Be good, fellas. Boy, all in with you, they just power bearers. And if we ball catchers, remember, sip slow, live fast. Young money, stay young. I've been cash money since day one.
No new friends, no new friends, no new new. Still here with my day one, so you hear me say, no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no new new. Still ride with my day one, don't really need no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no new friends.
Stay young, been cash money since day one.
Stay down from day one, so I say, no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no new new. Stay down from day one, so I say, no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no new new. Stay down from day one, so I say,
you don't need nothing. High class niggas.
This shit sound crazy. This shit sound crazy.
Flash shit only. You know what I'm saying? $1,000 pair of shoes, you don't even know. $1,000 propylene, you don't even know. This $500,000 car, you don't even know. I came up from the bottom, you don't even know. My niggas all right with me, you don't even know. Got killers with me right now, you don't even know it. This $1 million watch, nigga, you don't even know it. Got $1 million crib, nigga, you don't even know it.
Ayy, that monster truck sit tall as fuck, so big, can't even talk. Don't like snakes, keep my grad cut so low, can't even more. Tip done, period, look hot, glow, no, no, we don't do more. If it ain't PJ, no rosé for me, host don't even pour it. Spent some time for it. Button down Michael Kors. Always on like the refrigerator unplugged, then ho, you know it. AP and that P gate with a bright lean when I'm bored. Got a masterpiece and a 41 millimeter, you ain't even know it. Keep the 45 in my pocket, I ain't gon' show it till I have to pop it, then you gon' know it. Damn, who shot you, they don't even know it. Hawks game, fucking Floyd. TV seat, front row it. Rocco the Dunn, CEO it. Ain't got a rapper, you know it. Nah.
$1,000 pair of shoes, you don't even know. $1,000 propylene, you don't even know. Just $500,000 car, you don't even know. I came up from the bottom, you don't even know. My niggas all right with me, you don't even know. Got killers with me right now, you don't even know. This $1 million watch, nigga, you don't even know. Got $1 million crib, nigga, you don't even know.
That nigga show you that re-rock, you ain't even know it. I die over these Reeboks, you ain't even know it. Put Molly all in her champagne, she ain't even know it. I took her home and I enjoyed that, she ain't even know it. Got 100 acres I live on, you ain't even know it. Got 100 rounds in this AR, you ain't even know it. Got a bag of bitches I play with on cloud 9 in my spaceship. Zoned out, but he stay fresh from zone 1 through zone 6. Bricks all in my blood, birds all in my dreams, boats all in my yard, lemon pepper my wings. I'm about to get you fucked, niggas whack. You ain't even know, your main nigga about to turn his back. You ain't even know.
It's $1,000 pair of shoes, you don't even know. It's $1,000 propylene, you don't even know. Just $500,000 car, you don't even know. I came up from the bottom, you don't even know. My niggas all right with me, you don't even know. Got killers with me right now, you don't even know. This $1 million watch, nigga, you don't even know. Got $1 million crib, nigga, you don't even know. You turned up every day, you don't even know. Got your bitch with me right now, you don't even know. We turn up in the club, you don't need nothing. Got a 100 bottles coming, you don't need nothing. We came up from that, you don't even know it. Drive a $500,000 car, you don't even know it. These $1,000 pair of shoes, you don't even know it. Got bitch speak no English, you don't even know it.
Throw it up, watch it all fall out. Bow it up, that's how we ball out. Throw it up, I fall out. Pull it up, pull it up. That's how we fall out. Strip clubs and dollar bills. Still got more money. Patron shots, we're gonna get a refill. Still got more money. Strippers going up and down that pole. Still got more money. 4 o'clock and we ain't going home. Still got my money.